All right, Reverend White, how do you react to your friend Jerry Falwell?
Well, you know, I know his family, and I cried for them. I cried for the church. He was a good pastor, a good father. He was a good president of the university, but I also cry for my brothers and sisters who are lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender, who have been victims of Jerry Falwell's anti-gay rhetoric. I just wanted so much for him to change and be able to say, God loves gays, God created gays, and God wants us to celebrate and accept our own our sexuality. But he never said that, so I'm weeping today because I've lost my chance to make a difference with him.
Did you ask him to say it?
Oh, many, many times, yeah. He just looked at me strangely. He really believed, even though he was sincere, though he was sincerely wrong. But I couldn't get through to him the fact that gay people are good Americans, that gay people are Christian and Jewish and Muslim, that gay people are at the heart of this country. Mm-hmm. He never could see it, even though they were part of his ministry, a part of his student body, a part of his church.
Is he going to be remembered as a pastor or a political figure?
I think he'll be remembered as both. For the gay community, we remember him as a person who gave us voice. He mobilized us. He became the face of homophobia. And we have to thank him because a lot of gay and lesbian, bisexual, transgender people have marched, taken their own steps towards getting justice because of Jerry Falwell. So I think he'll be remembered by the gay community as the worst person in terms of misinformation about us, but as a great person for mobilizing us for justice.
As a gay man, Reverend White, how could you have worked with him?
Well, I didn't know I was gay when I worked with him. I thought homosexuality was a sickness or a sin like he did. Then I learned, thank God, that it was not. It is a gift from God, not a sickness nor a sin. Once I learned that, then I was free to go back to Jerry and say, you know, when I worked with you, I didn't understand that gays are God's children too. And I need to tell you the tragic consequences of your rhetoric against us. Of course, he was deaf to that appeal.
And you had no inclination you were gay when you worked with him?
Oh, I was struggling with what I thought was a sin, Larry.
No.
I've only known same-sex attraction, so I thought what the church told me was true. But the church had told me wrong, as they were wrong about slavery and they were wrong about apartheid, as Jerry was. Jerry was a real racist during the civil rights movement, you know, and he changed. A few years ago, he got the NAACP award here in Lynchburg. That's why I thought he might change about us. Now he hasn't. It's too bad.
Thank you all very much.